What is going on, everyone? Anthony Drew Gary here, host of the How To Show, where we talk about optimizing life, money, and happiness one how to at a time. Before I get started on this week's episode, I feel like somebody listening might appreciate the fact that I just recorded this entire episode only to find out that the recorder wasn't actually working. So this should be really well polished and well thought out because I already did it once and now this is the second time through on it. And this week we're gonna talk about real estate again in such a way that maybe you can save a little bit of money by removing the mortgage insurance portion of your housing payment. So to do a recap, I did a prior video on how to calculate what a mortgage payment might look like, and I'll link to that overhead. But in this specific episode, we're gonna talk assuming that somebody has put down less than 20% when they originally bought their house, and through one reason or another, be it accelerated principal pay down or paying your mortgage off and getting that incremental payment to go toward your principal, or market appreciation, you might now find yourself in a situation where you do have that 20% down. And so we're gonna talk about what it looks like to try to get that PMI or MIP based on the different types of loan products available. We're gonna talk about what it might look like to get that removed from your payment. So that's something that you can direct those savings towards something else, or just ultimately get your mortgage payment down a little bit. So the key to this is that you have to get information that is specific to the type of loan that you signed and closed on when you bought your house. And so there are gonna be different tweaks and different rules for this, whether or not you have an FHA loan, whether you have a conventional loan, whether you have a VA loan, or any other type of loan. All of these programs work slightly differently. So you're gonna wanna call your mortgage servicer and make sure that you're getting accurate information based on your situation. But as a general rule, if you come to find out that you have more than 20% equity, which basically means the value of your house minus what you owe is more than 20% of that value, there stands to be a decent chance that you have some options. So let's go through this and we'll start and talk about a different couple of different ways to look at it, but it all starts with calling your mortgage servicer and finding out your specific situation. And so you make your phone call and you say, hey, I think that I've got 20% equity in my house, and based on that, I would like to talk to you about what it might look like to remove that mortgage insurance premium. And so the first thing that could happen is that you could be told that the way that your loan is structured, you may not be eligible to do that. You may have signed a loan that suggests that you're going to pay mortgage insurance for the entirety of the life of the loan. And if that is the situation you find yourself in, you may need to have a refinance done in order to get your PMI out of the way. And that has an additional cost to it. The whole refinance process is a video in itself, but that could be a solution. And so we'll set that to the side for a minute. The next possibility is that you call and you suggest that, hey, I believe I've got 20% equity in my house. I would like to get my mortgage insurance premiums waived or removed. And you could hear back that you have to do some sort of validation to prove that this is true. And so this is very common. Usually it will involve an appraisal process. And so the mortgage originator or the mortgage servicer is going to want to send an appraiser out to validate what they think your house is currently worth. And so there's a catch to this, and that's that the mortgage servicer is not going to pay for this. This is something that you're gonna have to pay for. So I recommend before you pay for an appraisal, you get somebody in your corner, such as a real estate agent or somebody who really knows the real estate market in your area, to give you a good assessment of what they believe your house might be worth, because you don't wanna waste the assessor's time. You know, if you think your house is worth $200,000 and your house is only worth $115,000, I know that's a big jump, but the idea there is that you wanna make sure that if you're gonna pay to have an appraisal done, which is usually several hundred dollars, that you have a good chance of getting the outcome that you want out of the back end of this. And so let's continue this thought process out. You have an appraiser that comes out and they say that your house is now worth this amount that is substantially more than you bought it for a couple of years ago, or maybe even a handful of months ago. The local real estate market in most areas has been booming lately, and so based on that, it's not out of the question that whatever you paid for your house a little while ago, it's worth a decent amount more now. And so you can use that to your advantage, and hopefully with a combination of that plus your down payment, plus the amount of principal that you've been paying over the year, over the months that you've been making your mortgage payments, if you can get to where all of those items equal 20% equity in your house, you stand a chance to get that mortgage interest premium removed from your loan. And so if you can get that proven, there's a good chance that the mortgage loan originator will find some way to work with you to get that PMI dropped. And that's just really an added savings to you based on current market conditions. So if you can get that removed, usually mortgage insurance premiums are averaging somewhere between $80 to $120 per every $100,000 that you finance. So if you financed $100,000 to $300,000, that could be anywhere from $100 to maybe $350 per month that you could save off of that mortgage payment just because you knew the situation that you were in and that you were able to take advantage of, again, that market appreciation, the fact that you've paid down some principal, and add that on top of the down payment that you made in the first place. So really there's two options here. You can either get out of your PMI by proving that you've got 20% equity, or you can attempt to refinance that mortgage, and you know that at that point you'll be able to prove that you've got 20% equity in it that way. So hopefully there's somebody that's watching this video that might be in this situation. If you're in an area where the real estate market is really hot and houses are selling quickly, there's a good chance that the house that you own is worth a lot more than what you paid for it in the first place. So this is something worth doing for a lot of people that could save some money and really get yourself into a position where you could deploy that cash onto something else, you know, paying off debt, saving for retirement, or just enjoying it because you've figured out the rules to this game. That is all for this episode of the show. Hopefully there was something useful there that you can take advantage of. And if this isn't the phase of life that you're in, if there's somebody that is that you can share this with, it's all the better if you do. Hopefully we can get this information in front of somebody that can use it and it can be of benefit to them. And hopefully they'll be able to save some money doing it. So if you like what you're watching out of my show or out of my channel, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and you'll be the first to know about new content as it comes out. And if you leave me a comment with your feedback or an idea for a future topic for the show, I will respond to you. I have a good time doing that. And as always, I appreciate anybody who's checking out the channel. If you share it with somebody, hopefully they'll be able to get benefit from it too. Until next time, this is Anthony Drew Gary, host of The How To Show, signing off.